Researching the life cycles and populations of the monarch butterfly are main topics of discussion for wildlife biology students at the University of Minnesota in St. Paul. The beautiful orange and black butterfly has been on a steady decline by 90% in recent years. It's the result of a loss of habitat or milkweed due to urban sprawl, agricultural practices, development and cropland conversion, in addition to the loss of wintering habitat in Mexico and California. From the research lab to the greenhouse with milkweed and the classroom for practicum studies, these students are hoping their efforts could help be a saving grace.
I was taking the monarch caterpillars out of the incubator and feeding them this tropical milkweed. First, we empty out the old leaves from the container and empty them into the compost. And then we add fresh leaves to the container and then put them back into the incubator to keep growing. And I also record the instars, when they're growing day by day.
Monarchs are a particularly good model organism for chemical ecology, as well as migration of insects. So I study mostly the chemical ecology portion of their biology and how much of a conservation concern parasitoids or other invertebrate predators or other natural enemies might be to monarchs.
Many of these students are members of the Monarch Joint Venture, headquartered at the University of Minnesota. The organization is a collaboration of state, federal, non-governmental agencies, and academic programs that are pooling their efforts to protect monarch and pollinator habitat across America. Dr. Karen Oberhauser, biology professor at the University of Minnesota, is chair of the Monarch Joint Venture.
Monarchs need breeding habitat during the spring and summertime, and that breeding habitat occurs first in the southern United States, and then as it gets hot down there, they move up into the northeastern. So if you just imagine the northeastern quarter of the United States, it's a huge area, and they move into that area. They need milkweed plants for the caterpillars to eat, and they need nectar plants for the adults. So they go through two or three generations up here in the north. And then, so they need habitat then, and then they migrate back to Mexico. So we know that the numbers are declining, and people notice this. People notice that they're not seeing as many butterflies in their gardens, they're not seeing as many butterflies during the migration in the fall and the spring. So people are really concerned about this.
Such concerns are addressed in state wildlife action plans. Every 10 years, U.S. Congress requires each state to develop a proactive plan for a vast array of wildlife, including amphibians, birds, and reptiles, before they become rare and more costly to protect. And yet a federal strategy is now in place to promote the health of honeybees and other pollinators, including the monarch butterfly. In fact, the species is listed in the Minnesota state plan.
So back in 2005, we really hadn't heard much about the declines in the monarch. But over the past few years, that's been coming more and more to our attention. And so when our experts took a look at that list, particularly the butterflies and moths sections, the monarch did meet a number of the criteria for species of greatest conservation need. So while it wasn't listed in our initial plan, it is going in for our 2015 plan and will be considered a species of greatest conservation need in Minnesota.
Communities across the states can also make a difference by planting milkweed in their yards. Monarch Joint Venture members say more schools, businesses, and residents are getting involved.
We support teachers with professional development and funds to install gardens in their on their school grounds. And that gives a teacher another access point for teaching science, as well as providing extended habitat for all kinds of native pollinators, including the monarch butterfly.
It's important for the states to get involved, one, because they own a lot of land, or there's a lot of land that's potential habitat for monarchs and other pollinators, and also other wildlife. So just making sure that monarchs are a part of their plan enables them to really do good conservation work for monarchs, which is also good for other pollinators.
Meanwhile, there's optimism with continued support from partners and communities. The monarch butterfly will thrive.
I think it's great to see people getting involved. I mean, in the past year and a half, I've seen so many people come up to us with more interest on monarchs, wondering how they can help. And just having the states involved at the government level just kind of increases that awareness and increases that desire for other people to be involved as well.
Monarch conservation, it's getting a lot of attention, and all of the great research that people are doing around monarchs, the research, the education, the monitoring, the conservation. There's just so many things going on that I am hopeful for the rebound of a monarch population.
In Washington, Kim Betton, Wildlife and Sport Fish Restoration Program, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, Department of the Interior.